Well, thank you very much for having the IEA here and as a partner for this particular conference. Let me thank CEEW in particular, Arunaba, and the rest of the team. It's just a phenomenal team to work with. We've had a partnership from the IEA for many years. I suspect others in the room have partnerships with CEEW, and congratulations on all your progress and for what has been so far a terrific conference. I just got here late last night, so I got to see this morning's sessions, which were terrific. And I heard yesterday as well was great, especially the debate towards the end of the day, which I heard was very lively and entertaining and interactive as well. So thanks to CEEW. Thanks also to India, certainly for the partnership with the IEA. India is now squarely within the IEA family as an association partner. It's been that way for the last year and a half or so. And just an incredible partnership where we're just expanding our bilateral work from the IEA side of things. So thanks to those like our additional secretary and MNRE for the partnership, but others in the room as well. And thank you very much for India's leadership more generally in the clean energy transitions. It's just terrific to see such progress as we just heard on the renewables front, the solar front in particular, but other progress that's happening on efficiency, electric vehicles, other kinds of things as well. So what I've been asked to do is to take a little bit of a step back here and give you some global numbers and some India numbers on how we're doing in the clean energy transition more generally. So I'm gonna pull some of our latest analysis, numbers, trends, et cetera, hopefully putting some of the discussions so far in this conference into a little bit of perspective. So first, how are we doing overall? So if you look at greenhouse gas emissions, we're frankly not doing that well. In fact, we're doing quite poorly. 2017 was a particularly bad year for emissions from the energy sector globally. We'd actually seen a flattening off in 2014, 2015, and 2016 of overall GHG emissions, greenhouse gas emissions for the world. That's the first time ever we've seen a flat level of emissions from the energy sector, while we also saw healthy global GDP growth. So a lot of us were hopeful that we were delinking from GDP growth for emissions. Unfortunately, 2017 showed us that we have a lot more work to do. The 2017 number was an actual increase of 1.4% overall in the world on GHG emissions from the energy sector. 1.4% is a lot of additional emissions. And showing from the emission side of things, the greenhouse gas emission side, we are not on track. We're frankly quite off track. We obviously have other issues with the energy sector as well. Air pollution, of course, is a real big challenge, certainly a big challenge in India, a big challenge in China, frankly, a big challenge all over the world. I live in Paris, France right now, and it's a challenge in Paris, France as well, so the air pollution problem. We also have energy access issues, water issues, all sorts of other issues as well that, of course, CEEW and others are working on also. One thing that we did just last year was put together a new scenario looking not just at how we can achieve our climate objectives, the Paris objective, the well below 2 degrees Celsius standard, but also at the same time achieve air pollution reduction targets and energy access for everybody by 2030. It's something we call our sustainable development scenario. It's an integrated scenario trying to figure out how we can achieve all of these objectives together in the world. What it shows is many things. First, it shows we're woefully off track and there's a huge gap from where we're going. Our kind of status quo scenario, if you will, still has global emissions on the greenhouse gas side going upwards even to 2040. The SDS scenario, the sustainable development scenario, peaks immediately and goes down quite significantly. So the gap between the two is quite large, to say the least. What it also shows is the importance of both renewables and efficiency. So if you put together renewables and efficiency, that in our scenario is 80% of the equation to get us onto that more sustainable future, that greenhouse gas sustainable, air pollution reductions and energy access as well. So 80% of all of the policy efforts, the finance efforts, are in efficiency and renewables. One other exercise we've just done recently, we have a brand new interactive website. You can go and explore the numbers yourselves, put together your own graphs, compare how India stacks up with the rest of the world. It's something we call our Tracking Clean Energy Progress Report. So we look at how different technologies, 38 different technologies, 38 different sectors, compare to achieving or not achieving, doing their part to help us get to that sustainable development scenario. So out of 38 different technologies, what we find are there are only 4 technologies that are actually on track. 4 of 38 technologies actually doing their share, seeing the kind of deployment numbers, seeing the kind of finance numbers that give us confidence that they're doing their part to allow the world to get the world into that sustainable development scenario. So obviously 4 of 38 is not a significantly high number, less than 10%. We have a lot of work to do in a variety of different technologies. Now let me just go a little bit more in detail in some of those key sectors and technologies. This is a renewables conference, so let me give you some renewables numbers. We break out the renewables piece, and my colleague Paolo Frankel, who you heard from yesterday and today, is the head of this analysis. When we look at all the renewables technologies, there's only one renewable technology right now that's on track, that's actually doing its share, that the numbers are increasing, and that's solar PV. No surprise, I think, for those who are following that issue. Certainly India has been a global leader on those issues, as we just heard from some of the terrific deployment numbers. Over 90 gigawatts of installed capacity additions last year. That is a very, very significant number, and significant increases from previous years as well. Every other renewable technology, though, is off track. Even wind, onshore wind, which had been green before, had been on track before, we've seen decreases over the last 2 years of additional capacity additions from wind globally. So just a bit of a wake-up call. Even though there's a lot more wind coming on, it's less each year than we've seen over the previous couple years. And when you look at geothermal, CSP, concentrated solar, ocean technologies, those are what we categorize as red, even worse, not on track at all, not making much progress at all. Now there's some good R&D going on, there's some interesting examples going on. India is working on some really interesting offshore technologies for both wind and solar, but overall, globally, we're not nearly on track, those other renewable technology pieces. The other part of the renewables equation that we're spending a lot of time, and again, it's Paolo's team who's working on this at the IEA, is the systems integration piece. So great that we're adding all these renewables on, especially wind and solar, the intermittent renewables, but we've got to have flexible grids. We've got to have storage solutions that can deal with these increasing amounts of renewables so that the overall system works. It's an area we're really ramping up. It's probably the largest growth area for the IEA, frankly, overall. And it's an area in particular we've got a very extensive partnership with India, Niti Aayog, the Asian Development Bank in particular. We just had 4 regional workshops in April around the country to really try to help channel the global expertise in this area, bring it in the Indian context, and frankly learn from what India is doing so that we can export that and share that with our other members and partners around the world. So that's the snapshot on the renewables front. Let me just highlight a couple other areas that I think would be of interest to this particular audience. Efficiency. Efficiency was not a good year in 2017 as well. We'd seen some particularly impressive efficiency improvements in certain areas. The bright spot, the one efficiency technology that's actually on track, is LEDs. LEDs have been increasing in terms of deployment, decreasing in terms of costs. 2014, 1 out of every 10 light bulbs or light installations in the world were LEDs. LEDs, as many of you know, are about 9 to 15% more efficient than the traditional incandescent light bulb. So huge efficiency gains that we see on the LED side. In 2014, it was 1 out of every 3 light bulbs sold. In 2017, it was 1 out of every 10 in 2014. In 2017, is 1 out of every 3. Our projections are very healthy going forward to the point where we'll have about 80% of light bulbs sold in the not too distant future, about 12 years from now in 2030, being LED technology. That's huge efficiency gains. A great story for R&D investment, and frankly, a great story for some real policy drivers, procurement drivers. And India deserves a lot of credit in this instance for some of the very aggressive, ambitious policies, the Ujjala program, more generally Indian leadership on this issue as well. One other bright spot, a technology that's of course related to renewables, is electric vehicles. Electric vehicles, for the first time, we saw over 1 million electric vehicles sold in 2017. That's a 54% increase from the numbers in 2016. So it's ramping up significantly. Now, to put this in some perspective, 1 million vehicles sold in the world is significant, but it's 1% of vehicles sold in the world in 2017. So the ramp up is very impressive, but we've got a long way to go to get to the levels of electric vehicles to help reduce air pollution, to help reduce greenhouse gas emissions going forward in that instance. A few numbers on the clean energy investment side. Policy is absolutely critical, but investment is significant as well. It's an issue, of course, that this conference is taking head on, that CEW and others are working on significantly. Let me give you two numbers for you on the investment on the clean energy side of things. When we look out to 2040, which is really not that far off from here, 22 years from now, our scenario, our sustainable development scenario, has twice as much investment in renewables in 2040 than we have now. So that's the scale of investment challenge on the, just looking at the renewable side of the clean energy equation. If you look in the India specific context, 2017, and our latest numbers for investment will be coming out in our annual investment report, which will be released here in just a few weeks. For the first time ever in India, we actually saw more investment in renewables than we saw in fossil fuel generation. That's the first time that that's ever happened in the India context, obviously a very significant and important trend going forward. We just are releasing at this conference a joint work project that we've done with CEEW on clean energy investment. My colleague Mike Waldron, working with a very talented team here in CEEW, put out a joint effort looking at both the progress on the Indian investment side of the equation, but also some things we need to work on going forward as well. I know we'll get into some of that in the next session as well. Now, one very important part of investment that is another bright spot on the overall clean energy transition front is investment in research and development, investment in innovation. What our numbers showed, and we've been tracking investment in innovation for many, many years, what we showed over the last 5 years in our numbers was basically flat levels of global investment in clean energy research and development. Now, that's not a good trend if you need the kind of investment we need to really get all of these technologies, to take those 34 technologies that aren't on track and really getting them on track. It's a huge need for investment, huge need for research and development. What we saw in 2017 were very encouraging signs, a 13% estimated increase going above, for the first time, global public government investment in research and development, over 20 billion US dollars just in 2017. So a 13% increase, which is a very significant amount of increase. And again, a lot of credit to India on that. One of the main drivers of that is an initiative that India helped lead. In fact, your Prime Minister Modi named this initiative the Mission Innovation Initiative, of which India is very much one of the leaders. We're hoping the Mission Innovation Ministerial Meeting will be here in a couple of years' time. India has led this effort from the get-go, not only showing, walking the walk domestically, but leading internationally as well. And this initiative is really showing this, helping to drive this 13% increase going forward. So in conclusion, let me just leave you with this. All eyes in the international space, and that's where Paolo, myself, others of us at IEA work, when it comes to clean energy transition, really is in India. This is where things are happening. We just heard about the exciting things happening from the additional secretary for MNRE on the solar fronts, from the renewable front, the systems integration front, some of the efficiency fronts. India really is where the action is, if you will. It's why we're so excited to partner with CEEW and the Indian government more generally. So there's not only pressure on all of you domestically with the 1.3 billion people here in India to make their lives better, but India leadership, frankly, is necessary for the world, and we're happy from the IEA to channel some of those positive experience, some of the success stories from the Indian side, and really working with you in partnership and even closer partnership going forward to achieve the successes, the promise, the potential of this clean energy revolution that's happening right now. So again, thanks for having IEA here. Thanks for the partnership, and really looking forward to enhancing that partnership going forward. Thank you.